Worst dates you ever had. Maybe it was on you. Like, maybe you did something that was... Okay, sorry, Cher.
No.
Maybe the rest of us.
Yeah, we're all normal. We're all normal.
Maybe you did something that was, like, awkward or weird or, like, not good first date etiquette. Like, what were the worst? The worst ones?
I never really went on dates. Okay, it's like, I feel like I've been in a relationship for 30 years. I haven't. It's been nice. But, like, even, like, in high school...
For 30 years.
In high school, it's not like I had, like, a boyfriend all the time. Like, yeah. I was weird looking and weird as a person. So, like, it just...
Were we all?
But, like...
At some point or another. Yeah.
My boyfriend and I, like, we switch off anniversary dates. So, like, one year he'll take me out and the next year I take him out. So, blah, blah, blah.
That's nice.
So, I think the first, maybe second time that it was my turn...
Yeah.
We went to Pizza Hut.
Nice, classic.
Romantic, there were screaming children.
Where love is born.
Oh, no.
We had stuffed crust, so.
Ooh.
That's a plus.
That was like an innuendo for later.
Oh, stuffed crust. Not really a bad date, I guess, but I'm sure he would beg to differ because he took me to like the golf steakhouse.
Ooh,
and I'm like, ooh, stuffed crust.
Came back with Pizza Hut.
Yeah, I'm bad at ideas. Don't
ever
ask me to
choose. Did the golf happen before the Pizza Hut?
I think so. Like, I guys, it's been so long. I don't remember.
Oh, no.
But I think it did. I think that was, like, our first anniversary, and then I think Pizza Hut was our second anniversary.
Yeah.
So
I really lived up to, you know, relationship standards.
Yeah.
But
he kept you around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was nice of him.
I'm lucky.
I haven't had catastrophic things. But on, like, one date I went out with this guy when I was in university. Nice guy. We went out for dinner, like, normal date, good conversation, having a good time. And then we were leaving, and he goes, do you want to go hang out with my sister? And I was like, thought about it. I'm like, it's not, like, a weird thing. But I was like, it kind of, I just met you. Mm-hmm. You want me to come hang out with your family? Like, like, too soon.
Right.
So that turned me off. There was not a second date. That turned me off big time because I was like, that is very, again, like he was being polite and friendly, but that was very strange to me.
Yeah.
I don't know. Meeting family on the first date.
Was there going to be anybody else there or was it just
her and her husband? So it'd be like it'd be like a double date.
A married
couple. Yeah.
No.
And then,
I liked it.
It would be like, it'd be like the first time you go to a family function, like of your significant others, and you know how they're like hounding you with questions on the first date.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Sisters,
where do you go to school?
Hard.
Oh my God. Yeah. Her baby brother. I'm like, no thanks. Please drop me off at home.
Yeah.
Went home, went to bed. I'm like, nope. Done. Not answering that text message.
Like, I can't. I have to curl my hair and paint my nails.
I have to wash my arms today.
Yeah.
Busy.
I have a lot of plans.
Oh, goodness. Okay. Any bad?
I had a realization. I was thinking.
Oh my God. I want to hear
that. It's not that crazy, but I was on a date and the guy that I was on a date with said that he was trying to do some Kijiji deal, and I guess somehow,
oh my God,
like, as he's telling me this,
is this a murder story?
No, but he said he almost got kidnapped by these people trying to do a Kijiji thing, and I was thinking, who are you?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, and then he ended up driving me home, and then at that point, I just wanted to get out of the car, and I went to close it and left, and apparently I didn't close the door. And he had to, like, drive down the street and, like, reach over.
Oh,
I know. But I was like,
I feel like I want to know so much more.
I still have his number.
What was he purchasing?
Yeah.
It must have been like, I think it was some kind of phone, like a smartphone. This is like maybe 8 years ago.
Was it a flip
phone? No. No, maybe
was it a
torch. I'm thinking something like that.
Yeah.
Okay,
but
cool.
Someone was trying to rip someone off and someone got grabbed into a van and got out anyway.
That's dramatic.
Yeah.
Goodness.
But that's like the only thing I have that I can remember.
Okay, do you have anything? Or can we go right to online dating, which...
Well, okay, I can mesh both.
Let's hear it. I want to hear
about transition.
This. Yeah.
Okay, I have been single for nearly 2 years. November 1st will be 2 years.
Your single-versary.
Happy single-versary.
Almost there. And for me, it's just like the bad behavior, even before the first date starts. Just, I don't know if I've just had weird luck this year, but I had this one guy who we were planning to go on a date so many different times, and he kept bailing on me every single time. But he seemed interested, and it, you know what? That's happened to me. Like, it happened to me last week.
It's become so easy to ditch.
Because there's no, like, face-to-face connection.
And they don't have to say it to you, like, with their voice. So it's just like, hiding behind a keyboard.
And I joined Bumble. I never do online dating, and I joined Bumble, I don't know, a few weeks ago. And I was on it for 4 days. And I deleted the app. I just couldn't. Like, I thought there were so many cool prospects, like just other healthcare professionals on there who were super sweet, and we would talk. And then, you know, I would clearly hint towards a date, like, what are you up to this weekend? As in, do you want to go out for a coffee or a drink? And they'd be like, go to a music festival. How about you? That's not where I was going.
A quiet night in.
And Cher keeps telling me that I did it totally wrong, that I just like wasn't swiping the right
guys. You're not judging hard enough. She needs a better vetting process.
You have to swipe to the proper people. However, I mean, I always ended up going on the dates. Like, I didn't have like too much of a problem. Maybe I was just more direct, or I just like didn't want to talk as long, like via text. But like then I went on the date and I was like, maybe I shouldn't have swiped. Because so one guy, we met for a beer and we were chatting and everything like that, and we had both just built homes. So we had a lot to talk about in that sense. It's like, oh, like, how was your process? This was my process and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then he brought up his ex-girlfriend
of
4 years who was a stripper.
That just got worse and worse.
Right? There's no problem with that career choice.
Yeah, I'm just curious to see where this is going.
He just wasn't over her, and he was saying, like, she is into this guy, and we dated for this long, and da-da-da, and I'm just, and it was so, I almost felt so bad that I went Dutch on the date. Like, every first date,
maybe that's
I make
strategy.
Them pay.
Maybe that's a strategy.
No, he wanted me. But like, that first date, he was like, I'll get it, I was like, no. No, trust me. You need this. Like, I will get it for you. And then someone else I went on an online date with, and it was Bumble too, I think. I showed up, and the photos that he had had to be from high school. And like, not high school where it was like he looked boyish. I just mean high school, like he was half the size in the photo. It had to be multiple years. He was half the size in the photo. Then when I met him, I didn't even recognize him in the restaurant.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh no. Oh, yeah. That's sad.
And then
classic with online. Sometimes you get a real surprise compared to what you anticipated.
And guys don't know what photos to put up. They just don't know.
They do like the mirror,
shirtless,
half naked, and straight face too.
Like it's gotta work, or else why would they do it?
Right.
Like, as women, we should band together and never swipe
for
a shirtless photo,
or like a guy with like six girls, and it's like, or like a group when people have group pictures,
and you don't know,
and they're like, group photos.
Who are you?
Oh, the worst is Hooters photos.
Interesting.
On an online dating profile?
Does it have a lot? Does
like, you can have that photo, but why do you choose to put it on an online dating
profile?
Right? Yeah, what message do you think you're sending to me?
I want a girl with boobs.
Big
pretty
ones.
Clear. That are fine with Hooters and chicken wings.
All the essentials.
Yes. The key points of my life.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay, speaking of dating, I don't know about you ladies, but I have weddings that are trickling into fall. So wedding season has not ended for me with summer. I've got them coming up still. Plus ones. So, I mean, Mark and I are in it to win it. We're each other's plus ones. But say you're dating somebody newish, and you get the wedding invitation. I feel like this day and age, we all get a plus one. Like, your friends are pretty good about giving their single friends a plus one. When do you decide it's the right time to bring someone? How long have you been dating? Is it taboo to ask them right away to come and anticipate that you'll still be together down the road? What's the protocol?
What do you think, Robin?
Well, we just got married last fall, and we were dealing with some people with plus ones. And
dealing with
it was a problem.
Because it was kind of like, okay, you're an adult, but we'll give you a plus one. Because we had really no children other than my newborn nephew. Mm-hmm. Like, the rest of them were 16 upwards, which were cousins or something.
Yeah.
And it's funny because we went out one night dancing at night school, and one of our friends, we thought somehow in Lost in Translation, this one woman was his date, and we absolutely hated her.
Oh, no.
And we're at the nightclub, and I'm saying to Gary, like, there's no way that she's getting invited. I will I'll tell him, like, he does not get a plus one if this isn't the person.
Yeah.
Because she was awful. She was drunk. She knocked people's drinks in their hands, didn't apologize, oh, didn't buy another one.
Yeah.
Just really,
that's
really
part of
rude.
The behavior. Yeah. You should know you buy them a new drink. And they usually become buddies.
Yeah, exactly. So I guess it depends on who it is. If the group of people that, like, you're getting married with and you know them and they know the plus one, I think that's okay.
I'm sure there are many people who are not pleased with whomever their guests' plus ones are. Like, I'm sure there have been many cases where they're not thrilled that they were the guest that was brought. But it's out of their hands, right? They gave the plus one.
Yeah.
I know it's hard. I'm sure it was hard to relinquish control and you weren't impressed, but...
It wasn't her.
Oh,
it was someone different! That's what I'm saying. It got lost in translation somehow.
Yeah. Okay, good.
I think they had the same name, but it was a different person.
Yeah.
Thank goodness. Good. Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Okay, you're single.
Yes.
Say you started seeing a guy. Sorry.
Yes, thank you.
Right around in my face.
Again, 2 years as of November 1st.
Just so everybody knows.
Say anyone has a single brother?
Say you start seeing someone nowish, and let's say, October, let's say he's got a wedding he's been invited to in, let's say, March.
Okay.
And you go on a few dates, you've been seeing each other for about a month.
Dates.
Yeah, you've been on a few dates, you guys have maybe had the conversation, are we committed, is this exclusive? And he says, listen, I've got this wedding coming up, I need to send in my RSVP, do you want to come with me?
And you said it's his friend's
wedding? Yeah, so it's like his buddy's getting married, he's got a plus one, he likes you enough to want to bring you to that.
Definitely.
You think so?
I don't know, for me it's... Maybe I'm just more carefree, but I think as long as his family is not going to be there or my family is not going to be there, if it's just his buddy's wedding.
So if it's a friend.
If it's just a friend.
Not meaning everybody, it was his brother's wedding. Well, that would be a little bit
intense.
And if
it's not in the
wedding.
Yes.
And
then you're alone.
That would be a whole different story, I would
think. Yeah,
definitely.
It's you and him sitting at a table with some friends.
Oh, 100%. Why not?
Okay. I mean,
open bar.
But I mean, if it doesn't work out, it's his problem.
It's not your
problem.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's move the conversation then.
Right.
I'm not going to ask you.
This happened to me.
So you get to pick the plus one.
Yeah, so I had a long-term boyfriend, and so my friend invited me plus one, knowing it was going to be him, to the wedding. We broke up solid 6 days before the wedding, and I just brought my girlfriend.
That's an easy switch.
I texted her, and I was like, we broke up. This is a plate you've already paid for, probably, right? It's a week before the wedding.
Yep.
Do you mind if I bring a girlfriend? And it was someone she knew, and she was like, of course. Like, of course.
I think that was good etiquette. Good courtesy. Yeah, letting the bride know before.
Yeah, but when we planned our wedding, I was ruthless.
Were you?
If you did not have... Yeah.
I can only
imagine. I did not, some of my bridesmaids didn't even get plus ones.
Wow.
Because, we wanted to cap it at 120.
Yeah.
And so we were okay, you start at the core, you move out, you're at the people you have to invite.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden there's no room left.
Yeah.
Right? And so it's
fair.
Unless you were living together or you're dating and I've met you and it's been a long time or you're engaged or you're his baby daddy or whatever, you did not get a plus one at all.
I think that's the technique most people are doing
now. It's expensive.
And if they haven't met your significant other, they will not invite or assume that you get a plus one.
And the other thing too is the people who didn't get a plus one were surrounded by their friends.
Yeah.
They
had a good time.
Yeah. Everyone had a good time.
Yeah.
They were sitting at tables where they knew people. I didn't say you have a boyfriend, but I'm not giving you a plus one and I'm sitting you at a table where you don't know anybody.
Awkward.
Like, everyone was really tight. Everyone had friends. And then we got some no's back. And then I actually reached out to a couple people and be like, hey, do you want to bring your girlfriend? Do you want to bring your boyfriend? Because we have these, five seats. I've paid for 120 people already.
Yeah.
And people then did that.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
That okay. sounds like it worked out great. Yeah.
Well, like, why am I paying that much money for a stranger to eat a meal to keep you company when you're sitting with a friend?
Yeah. What did you say? It was $1.99?
Yeah, $1.99 a person.
Plate, yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
And as the stranger, like, her if boyfriend. I didn't know the bride or groom, I'd be like, who are we celebrating? Yeah. Like, exactly. you feel a little bit odd being there on such an important day.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
like, with their family.
And you go up to tables and you talk. Yeah. I'm not going to go up to a table and introduce myself to people at a wedding.
Yeah. At your own wedding.
My wedding.
Oh, my God, no.
That's true. So I was ruthless. I was like, no, well, I don't care.
Cut to the chase.
Yeah. If we finished it and it was like 100, then yeah, I'd be like, okay, let's start plus ones.
Sure.
But it just worked. It worked out that way.
Okay.
And everyone seemed to understand. And if they didn't say anything to me.
Well, I think they would just know.
Yeah.
But lots about you.
The table gets like the most, oh my God, the most singles.
Thanks, everybody.
I'm just thinking like married, 10 years, 2.5 years.
Yeah.
2 years. 2 years ago. We did not plan that.
Yeah. No.